Welcome to the weekly Metals, Money, and Markets update for the week ending Friday, April 22nd, 2016, hosted by Mickey Fulp, the mercenary geologist, and for MiningClips.com, I'm Eric Birch. Hello, Mickey.
Hi, Eric. How are you?
Fantastic. We saw some strong gains in a few of the metals that we tracked this week, along with markets pushing some all-time highs. Let's start with the metals.
Well, we had a good week all in all. Gold was flat over the week, closed at 1232, but the real mover was silver, up 4.5%. It actually went above 1762 or something before it settled back just under 17, but a very strong move for silver. We've been expecting this. It lagged gold for a while, but now it's catching up. Copper was also strong over the week, up almost 4.5% and closed at 228.
Right. And moving on to energy, oil had a very strong week, and we also saw some developments in the uranium sector. What's your take on all that?
Well, it seems like the oil industry and the markets have ignored Doha and said OPEC be damned, with WTI up to 43.73, an 8% gain on the week. And what's really encouraging about the oil price, it's now exceeded its 200-day moving average. And anybody that follows markets know that that's a very bullish indication. On the other hand, uranium continues to show weakness. Just no short-term demand. Closed the week at 26.75. I should actually say it closed Thursday at 26.75. I don't get the uranium price on a daily basis until after we do this interview. But the real news from uranium space on Friday was Cameco is closing the giant Rabbit Lake mine in the Athabasca. And this was one of the first mines, and certainly in the top 15 of uranium producers in the world. And the reason is solely low prices, and 500 jobs are lost.
Wow. Obviously, demand is down, and Cameco's looking to cut costs with some of their higher operations.
Well, au contraire, demand is not down. Demand is rising, but there's an oversupply that's overhung the market since Fukushima.
Right. And on the currency front, the U.S. dollar showed continued strength along with the Canadian loonie this week.
Yeah, the dollar closed at 95 and changed, up about 0.5%. The real story here, again, is the loonie, up 1.3%. And that has totally to do with the price of oil. Your export revenues are so tied to oil, but it closes the week at almost 79 cents. That's good news for the Canadian economy.
And moving on to markets, we saw major U.S. indices more or less in consolidation mode near the end of the week, but also at all-time highs. The real mover, though, was the TSX Venture Exchange.
Well, the Dow and the S&P 500 are both pushing all-time highs, certainly yearly highs. Dow closed the week at over 18,000. S&P 500 is pushing right up to 2,100. Again, both only 0.5% gains, but this idea that markets were going to correct in the U.S. has proven wrong. Meanwhile, the real story, as you pointed out, has been the Toronto Venture Exchange. Closed the week at 656. Was off a little bit today, but that's another 3.5% gain on the week. And if you do the math from our low in mid-December of 466 on that index, we've now come up 41%. Since mid-December.
Those are some incredible gains, and largely driven by gold, right?
Absolutely. The Toronto Venture Exchange, although the majority of companies are not involved in the gold business on that exchange, gold is really what drives it.
Right. And while we're speaking of gold, we saw the gold-silver ratio continue to retreat this week. What's your take on that?
Well, it dropped down to 73, and it wasn't that long ago. In fact, a couple of weeks ago, it was still over 80. And we talked at PDAC about how rare that is. Since 1993, only 2 months in the record with a gold-silver ratio above 80, and what a strong buy signal that is for silver. Well, that's gone now. If you didn't buy silver, I wouldn't be buying it now. Although I can say that I think silver market looks bullish, and we expect it to continue to gain in the weeks ahead.
Thanks for your analysis this week, Mickey, and looking forward to checking in with you next week.
Absolutely, Eric. Let's hope that markets continue on this roll next week.